commitment to Christ, suddenly there was a change in their acumen. They began to operate as men of unusual wisdom. All you need to do is look at Peter's message on the day of Pentecost. I wonder how an illiterate can be so accurate in the presentation of the prophetic timing as it concerns God's plan for the people of God. He was a man whose acumen and whose mind had been sharpened in wisdom by the company of God. Remember, in the book of Proverbs 13:20, he that walketh with the wise shall be wise. God is the only wise God. You can't stay with him and lack wisdom. The moment you are committed to him, there is an upgrade in the wisdom of God at work in you. My prayer is that for each one of us, that wisdom that distinguishes, that sets people on high, that empowers people to rule in life, will begin to manifest in your life. Somebody believe it, say louder, amen. I said, somebody believe it, say louder, amen. Number two is supernatural fruitfulness. Supernatural fruitfulness. And this has to do with every area of life. He said in his Exodus chapter 23, verse 25 and 26, you shall serve the Lord your God. He will bless your bread and your water. He will take sickness away from the midst of thee. He said, none will cast their young, nor be barren in the land. The number of thy days I will fulfill. None will cast their young, nor be barren. So when you are engaged in spiritual stewardship, serving God, what happens is supernatural fruitfulness. Nothing is permitted to be barren. Nothing is permitted to cast her young. You have a business, it is bound to prosper. You get married, you are bound to have children. Everything about you is bound to produce fruit. That's what occurs when you begin to serve God. So your stewardship to God enhances your fruitfulness. Spiritual fruitfulness, physical fruitfulness, you know, career fruitfulness, material fruitfulness. In every department of life, you begin to enjoy fruitfulness. I see that becoming somebody's experience here. Somebody believe it, say louder, amen. I said, somebody believe it, say louder, amen. That is why for each one of us, we must position ourselves in this season, because the benefits are far beyond what any other organization can offer anyone. So we must engage with all of our hearts. We must engage the cry of faith. And as we do, watch God begin to decorate every department of your life. I see that becoming somebody's experience in the name of the Lord Jesus. Will you rise on your feet with me this morning? Lift your hand before the Lord and take grace from God. Lord, I receive grace from you this morning, the grace to engage with my heart, never to be divided, never to be distracted, never to be disconnected. I receive that grace this morning. Lift your voice and pray that prayer from the depth of your heart, from the depth of your heart, from the depth of your heart. From the depth of your heart, every operation of the enemy to bring about wanderings, distractions, to bring about disconnection, to bring about lack of connectivity. My Father, my God, I decree those obstacles removed out of the way. Grace to remain connected. Grace to remain connected. Grace to remain focused. Grace to remain undivided. I receive it now in the name of Jesus. Lift your voice and pray that prayer from the depth of your heart. I receive grace this morning. 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 I receive grace this morning, Lord. Lift your hand, lift your voice, and begin to give glory unto God for the unleashing of his grace, for the outpouring of his grace, for the manifestation of his grace that you are taking delivery of right now. Father, thank you. Blessed be your holy name. You are worthy of praise. In Jesus' precious name we have prayed. Another day is here. Another opportunity is before you. Operation 10 for Christ 2020 is on. We are all in pursuit of the lost. We are all in pursuit of everyone challenged, you know, winner. Everyone discouraged winner. We are pursuing them for their recovery. We are pursuing them for their restoration. I want you to speak into the day, including your kingdom target. This day is a day of blessing. It's a day of restoration for those that are being distracted, that are being dislodged by the enemy. It's a day of salvation for those that are lost. Lift your voice and decree, because you will decree a thing and it shall be established. And it will be done according to what you say. Speak to the day right now. The day is blessed. The day is open. And for this day, salvation will come to those that are lost. Lord, recovery and restoration to those that have been dislodged in the name of Jesus. The day is loaded with blessing, loaded with testimony. It will end in glory. This day will end with the glory of God crowning every labor that we engage. This day will end with the glory of God crowning every engagement that we put in the name of Jesus Christ. The day is they declare the day of blessing, a productive day, a fruitful day, a testimony day, an advancement day, a turnaround day, a lifting day, in the name of Jesus Christ. So shall it be in Jesus' precious name we have prayed. As you have decreed and declared, so shall it be done unto you. The day is declared blessed in Jesus' precious name. Amen and amen. Don't forget, we have our midweek service today, both here in Canaanland and across all of our zonal centers, across Lagos and the environs. Ensure that you are part of it and make sure your converts are also part of it, and God will visit each one in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's share the goodness together in fellowship. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Peace. It is my year of breaking limits. Then what eyes have not seen nor ears heard shall be your experience all through the year 2020. Congratulations. Amen and amen. Congratulate somebody as you go and be blessed.